Chris Chinnock here, Insight Media, CES 2025. I'm in the SWAVE booth. SWAVE was here last year. I did a video that described their technology. They use phase change material, which is part of their holographic display solution. This was developed for memories many years ago. They've repurposed it now for a holographic modulator. And so they can create very tiny pixels, a quarter of a micron, using this technology. And so the primary application that I'm going to be going after is AR glasses. So there's a number of elements they'll need to put together to realize that vision, and they're starting to put those pieces together, which we're going to talk about now. So last year they showed this demonstration, this modulator. This is a static modulator, which means you don't need power on it once the hologram is embedded, is encoded into it. And this is a, let's call it a negative hologram, so it appears to be inside the device. This is what they showed last year, this kind of a sphere with a bunch of holes in it. What they're showing this year is a positive hologram. So the demo over here allows you, this is a paper here, and being able to show the image on a piece of paper like this demonstrates it's a real image. And so you can see, looks like I'm capturing it okay. It comes into focus at this height above the device, and it actually expands quite nicely. There's a very high depth of field because it's a very small aperture. There's actually a second image encoded in this as well, much higher and a little bit dim to try and capture over here. There's a second demo over here. This one is dimmer because it's a larger image. This second image is quite hard to capture because of the camera. And they showed a similar demo last year using this camera and the illuminator and the chip to show that you can focus on two different depth planes. These are encoded into the chip. So you can, and they use the focus of the camera here to show that you can focus on this near plane, which has this image here, and a far plane, which has a second image on encoded on top of it. This is a second version of this demo now, featuring some classes that you can go through in a combining optic here. So again, near field and far field images demonstrate this. So for this modulator, they're using lasers, of course, since it's true holography. And to get full color, you're going to need three lasers, red, green, and blue. So there's a way you can obviously use three lasers and field sequentially address the chip to get full color. Another approach is to use color spatial filters, as in traditional LCDs, for example, or OLED displays. Now, the reason you might not want to use field sequential is because this is a bistable device. So when you write the hologram to it, you don't need any more power to keep it there. So if you're doing field sequential, you're constantly updating it, and it's kind of defeats the purpose of having a bistable device. So what they've chosen to do is actually a color filter approach, and they showed me an image of the pattern. I can't show that to you, it's proprietary, but it is a random pattern of RGB color filters that cover multiple, probably hundreds of those quarter micron individual pixels. This is still a proof of concept, but it's a way to get to full color at this point. Now, the other thing they want to have to also solve is for an AR device is how do you get that the image to your eyes. So this is a proof of concept demonstrator to do just that. So what you're looking at here is they have the device behind this big lens here. I guess it's a little hard to see. And then there's this eyeglasses here, and what you're seeing, this thin element here, is a holographic optical element. That's basically acting as a combiner and moving that that image and expanding it a little bit to be able to present it to the eye. And so we talked about color, we talked about a combiner. The next piece to talk about is compute. So what we're looking at here is a simulator that they've developed to show on this side. This is a webcam capturing this image right now. This is the holographic pattern that's being generated from this video image, and you can see it is moving in real time. And this is the simulated output as would be seen through their modulator. And you can see it doesn't have the clarity that of the video camera, because this is a very accurate representation of what you would actually see with your eye, according to Ed anyway.
That's correct. Yeah, that's correct. So this image here shows what you would see if this pattern were put onto a dynamic SLM and then illuminated with laser light. So we have a simulation of our dynamic depth feature, and we simulate this using two sliders. So the top slider tells the compute where it should render the image. So I set that to 1 meter. And the bottom slider says, where should I look at the reconstruction? Right? And that's also at 1 meter. So I render at 1 meter, my compute, I look at 1 meter, and this is what I see. Everything's in focus. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now I can change the top slider to move the position of the compute to, let's say, 0.1 meter. Right? And of course, if I place that plane at 0.1 meter, and then I look at 1 meter, everything's out of focus, and that's exactly what you should expect. Right?
Mm-hmm.
This is what the human visual system wants. Only one plane can be in focus at any one time. And of course, if I move the reconstruction distance to match the compute, now everything is back in focus. Right? And so I've moved the image plane from 0.1 meter to 1 meter, and I've done that entirely using compute.
Thank you, Ed. This is rendering at about 8 frames per second right now. It is using an FPGA for implementation of this algorithm. So if in a final implementation, obviously you want to go to an ASIC, but it's a rather modest, I think it was about a 22 nanometer node that could be used to create this compute. So it's a manageable kind of compute load at this point. So this is Chris Chenock for Insight Media.